Okay, this is m squared, and we have a few more equations that we're going to try to solve by getting the same base on both sides. These, you will notice, have fractions on them. So let's just recap that 3, or x to the negative 3, is equal to 1 over x cubed. So a negative exponent means that you are going to move that whole term either to the bottom if it was negative in the top, or to the top if it was in the bottom. But remember, a negative exponent is kind of like switching from the numerator to the denominator, or the denominator to the numerator. So for example, in this one, I know that 27 is 3 cubed. So I get 3 to the x equals 1 over 3 cubed, but I can't have it in the denominator. I need to move it up. Well, if I move it up, I have to make that a negative exponent. So it's no longer that, it's this. And once I get my bases the same, then what do I know about my x's? They're going to be the same. So x in this case is equal to negative 3. Let's try this one. This is in the denominator. To move it up, because I want everything to be in the numerator to solve my equation, I need to change the exponent to a negative. So I go 10, and then if I change the signs on both of those, the x will become positive and the 1 will become negative. So I've just made it like that. And then 100, I need to get it in the same base as 10. 100 is 10 squared. So now, this is what I have. And if I use my rule of powers, which means I multiply, I'm going to get 10 to the 8 minus 2x equals 10 to the x minus 1. Once the bases are the same, my rule says I can set exponents equal to each other. So x minus 1 equals 8 minus 2x. I need to get all my x's to one side, so I add 2x to both sides. Those cancel, I add 1 to both sides. Those cancel, I get 3x equals 9. I divide both sides by 3. X equals 3. You can always check. If I put a 3 back in here, I get 1 minus 3, which is negative 2. If I put that back, so we can check over here, it would be 10 to the negative 2. And then if we put a 3 there, we get 100. Oh, I'm sorry, this was 1 over 10 to the negative 2. We get 100 to the 1, which is just 100. This negative tells me I need to move it up. That becomes 100, and 100 does equal 100. So that's our check. Okay, this one looks a little tricky, but you'll notice there's a 2 here and a 3 here, and then you have a 27 and an 8, and you'll see that 3 kind of goes with 27, because 27 is 3 cubed, and 8 and 2 kind of go together, because 8 is 2 cubed. So we've got to flip it over. Remember how we flip it over? We've got to change the exponent to negative. So I can rewrite this as 8 over 27 as long as I change the signs on my exponent, so I'd have to change both of them. That's the first thing I want to do. Then I can worry about getting the bases the same. So 8 is 2 cubed and 27 is 3 cubed. So that means 8 over 27 is 2/3 cubed. We'll put another kind of bracket. And then all of that is to the negative x plus 4. So when I have a power raised to a power, I multiply. So I have now 2/3 is negative 3x plus 12. And it equals 2/3 to the 5x plus 1. So bases are the same. I can now set exponents equal to each other. So 5x plus 1 is equal to negative 3x plus 12. If I add 3x to both sides, I get 8x. If I minus 1 to both sides, I get 11. And x equals 11 over 8 when I divide both sides by 8. And indeed, that works if you check it. It's kind of a yucky check. I recommend that you check, especially if it's on a test, because then you know for sure if you're correct. But if you didn't want to check this one, I wouldn't blame you. And that's just a few of the fraction ones. I hope you enjoyed that wonderful lesson. This is m squared, signing out.